Chairperson, Mr. President, water is life. Our country is in the throes of what could become the worst drought in recorded history, with the South African Weather Services having already declared 2015 as the driest year since 1904. It cannot be said, however, that this was unforeseen, as the onset of the current dry season has been coming for a number of years, and entities such as the Water Research Commission have been predicting the current El Nino since at least 2013. And as such, government should have had contingency plans in place at local, provincial, and national level. Now, these contingency plans should include monitoring, early warning, and prediction systems, risk assessment and risk impact and assessment, mitigation and response programs, including proactive actions to reduce risks and response mechanisms to reduce the impact. What cannot be forgiven is the lack of planning and the inadequate and immediate response by our government to a crisis that threatens agriculture, food security, industry, and the residents of our country. The Minister of Water and Sanitation has been distinctly absent in this regard and has shown little interest in the drought and its impacts. The continued denialist attitude of this government is in stark contrast to the situation on the ground, where we see communities facing extreme water shortages and farmers across our country in a battle for survival. The actions of civil society expressed through groups like Operation Hydrate and Gift of the Givers and many others is commendable. But it is absolutely untenable, Mr. President, that civil society once again had to step in and do what our government could not or would not do. Mr. President, to put this crisis in perspective, without even taking the effects of the drought into consideration, 15 million people in South Africa are already unable to feed themselves on a daily basis. And 5.9% of all households are on the verge of what can only be described as starvation, according to Stats South Africa. The massive increase in food prices and the effects of job losses in rural areas are not being taken seriously by your government. The impact on our health and sanitation could also have further far-reaching consequences. The Democratic Alliance therefore renews its call for President Zuma to declare this drought a national disaster in order for all departments to assess the impact on their areas of responsibility. To leave this disaster in the hands of local and provincial structures without proper funding and capacity is irresponsible and short-sighted. Both Lesotho, which is one of our primary water sources, and Zimbabwe have declared the drought as a national disaster. And Botswana has indicated it will budget an additional $123 million for drought relief and water crisis effort. Yet our own government is found wanting. We have recently seen the taps of a number of communities run dry. Here, much of the blame needs to be placed on municipalities. Areas such as Koster and Swartruggens have issued a declaration of local disaster and haven't had water since December. And while the drought conditions have exacerbated the situation, it is equally true that a lack of maintenance of water infrastructure and a lack of management of water resources has resulted in average water losses at a municipal level in excess of 40%. Despite the progress in expanding access to water, reliability of supply is a growing problem. And what has the Department of Water and Sanitation been doing? They've been playing hide and seek with the blue and green drop reports. We had to resort to making a PIA application. And it's only through the continued pressure from the DA over the past weeks that the department finally uploaded the reports to their website. Their actions show an appalling lack of transparency. They are trying to hide the truth about South Africa's water supply and the quality of our water resources and sewage disposal systems from the South African public. These blue and green drop reports contain crucial information that the public needs to know, since these reports often contain warnings to members of a specific community not to consume their tap water without drinking it, without treating it first. So the question, Mr. President, is what are you hiding? What are you not telling us? And then in the last few months, we have seen Eskom threaten to cut off electricity at least 20 municipalities because of non-payment of arrear debt to the electricity supplier. Now, this punishes residents and businesses for the failure of the municipality to properly manage their finances. Both Selga and individual municipalities have raised the concern about the non-alignment of Eskom's billing processes with the MFMA, which requires that municipalities settle their accounts within 30 days of invoice. but Eskom starts charging interest from day 15. They've also pointed out that Eskom charges interest at prime plus 5%. Despite an interministerial committee having considered this matter, yes, another interministerial committee, for over 2 years, there appears to be little headway in resolving this. Mr. President, Section 139, subsection 5 of the Constitution requires the provincial executive, or your cabinet, where the provincial executive cannot or does not act, to impose a financial recovery plan on a municipality and dissolve the municipal council where it does not dissolve the municipal council, assume responsibility for the implementation of that recovery plan. I have personally written to former Minister of Cogta Praveen Gordhan on numerous occasions, as well as your new Minister of This and That, Des van Rooyen, requesting them to take this firm action. Sadly, I have to report that they have both defied the Constitution, much as you yourself did, and not taken the steps required of them. Now, Minister Gordhan's much-vaunted back-to-basics plan has resulted in some slight improvements at municipalities, but at the same time, almost an equal number of municipalities have regressed and fallen into the dysfunctional category. It remains to be seen whether Minister van Rooyen, the fifth Cogta minister in 7 years, will introduce yet another turnaround plan and once again put municipalities in turmoil. It is no surprise that the DA-run municipalities and provinces shine in comparison, because we put the needs of South Africans first. It is because the DA invests in infrastructure, ensures clean, efficient government, and delivers basic services to residents where it governs. Oh, and by the way, none of our municipalities are under threat of having their electricity cut off. The bottom line, Mr. President, is that the majority of South Africa's municipalities and provinces are failing because of poor ANC governance. The ANC of 2016 couldn't run a bath, especially given the current water crisis, let alone this country.